All right, guys, we are doing the Bible together again. We are reading the book of Zechariah. The name means Yahweh remembers. It's an Old Testament prophetic book about how God does not forget his people when they are feeling hopeless. We're at 520 BC. And what Zechariah does as a prophet of God is he speaks to the people about God's heart and gives godly directives to God's people. God's people have been in exile because their homeland was attacked and taken over by Babylonia, and then Persia took over them, and the leader of Persia said the Jewish people can go back home. The time in exile was about 70 years, and Zechariah's prophecies are towards the end of those 70 years. And God's people are wondering, is God going to show up for us? We'd like to go back home. We'd like to rebuild. But we don't feel like God remembers. Enter Zechariah to show them that he does. He has not forgotten about his people. I like this book because of so many reasons. One of it is that it reminds me that God has not forgotten me. I go through times in my life, sometimes where I feel like maybe I have been a little bit forgotten or something I'm going through doesn't matter to God. But this book shows that God's thinking about you. He's thinking about his people and you are always on his mind. Another really cool thing about Zechariah is there are images of Jesus all throughout the book. We're actually about to see one. So we're in Zechariah chapter 1. We are on October the 8th. And October the 8th is Zechariah chapter 1. Tomorrow, October the 9th, will be Zechariah chapter 2, and so on and so on. So the very first part of Zechariah chapter 1, we are seeing a major emphasis that really sets the tone for the book. And it is when Zechariah says, "Return to me." In verse 3, he says, God says, "Return to me. Return to me. Come back to me. Your forefathers messed up. Your forefathers did not pay attention to the major prophets that warned them that you were going to get hurt. You need to pay attention. Don't be like your forefathers. Don't be like your ancestors. Listen to me. God's ways are good for you. Listen to them. God's words still work." So Zechariah is a prophet. He was actually born in Babylonia. He was also a priest. He comes from a priestly line. But in this book, you see his prophetic leadership. Remember, priests talk to God about God's people. Prophets talk to people about God. And in this book, Zechariah is giving serious prophetic leadership to the people of God who have now come back home. They are returning from exile, praise God, and they're ready to rebuild. So we see in Zechariah chapter 1, the first of 8 visions. He has all of these visions in one night, very active night of dreams for this man. And we see 2 captured in Zechariah chapter 1. The first one is about a man among myrtle trees and a man on a red horse with a bunch of horses behind him. Now, who is this man? The Bible calls him the angel of the Lord. And a lot of scholars believe that when you see that phrase in the Old Testament, the angel of the Lord, it's a picture of Jesus. It's one of those potential pictures of Jesus among his people, protecting his people. There's some very, very clear pictures of Jesus that aren't so, I wonder if, in the book of Zechariah. You'll see some very clear images of Jesus. This one could be a picture of Jesus among his people, taking care of his people. He is the angel of the Lord, and he is upset about how God's people have been treated. In verse 15, he says, "I am upset at your enemies because they took it too far. They added to the calamity," in verse 15. "They were too harsh on you. Yes, these people were allowed to come in and take over, but they took it too far, and God is mad." And in verse 17, he says, "Jerusalem will prosper again." So this man with the horses and this man among the trees, his main emphasis there is that I am among you. You are downtrodden. You feel hopeless, but we are ushering into a stronger future for Jerusalem, and specifically the people of Judah. The next vision you see is where Zechariah sees these 4 horns, and a lot of people think these are just like these bronze metal horns. And when you see a prophecy about horns, it's usually about power, and there's 4 of them. We're probably talking about God's enemies being Assyria, Babylonia, Persia, Egypt could be in there, and potentially also Greece, because you see four horns and then 4 craftsmen. When it comes to the craftsmen, it may have been Greece. It doesn't really matter who it's about. What matters is what it's about. And it's about these powerful forces against God's people that had hurt them, and now things are going to get better. And the end of the book, at the end of the chapter, basically God is saying through Zechariah, God is going to take care of the people of Judah. I remember you. I remember you. I am not going to leave you alone. I know you feel hopeless, but I bring you hope. So Zechariah's prophetic leadership, as we examine this book together, Zechariah, what you're going to find is how God remembers his people and adds hope to hopelessness and provides protection among a bunch of threats. I think that all of us can relate with how that feels, and we're just getting started. We're about to see a lot more visions. We're going to see some really amazing pictures of Jesus. Get ready. It's kind of a wild ride. It's going to be awesome. So that's Zechariah chapter 1. Thank you so much for joining me. Look forward to doing this journey with you as we do the Bible together. Thanks, guys. We'll see you next time.